the partition of Bengal, Tilak was able to create a strong approach. That is, his group was called as extremist group, particularly. And then there was split of Congress in Surat session. Then ultimately he was charged sedition, and in 1908 he was taken to Mandale, that is in Myanmar. In those days it was called as Brahmadesh or Burma. As we have discussed, this is something British ideology, we can say, that king or emperor of Burma was sent to Ratnagiri, where the birthplace of Tilak is there. Tilak from Ratnagiri or Pune, he was sent to Mandale for imprisonment. Total 6 years of imprisonment was there. In that particular course, in 1911, Britishers were now in position to take back partition of Bengal. They did not it immediately, but after that they carried out the take back in partition of Bengal. In 1914, Tilak was rescued from Mandale. He wrote two different books, that is Gita Rahasya, and second original Arctic Home of Aryans in Vedas. But after rescue, the paper was not easy for him. Already Congress was divided. Then according to 1919 pact, the Muslims, particularly under influence of Muslim League, Muslims were having separate electorate. India, particularly the fighting people, they were divided. For example, Congress was split up into extremist and moderate. Again, Muslims were separated out to some extent. Not I am saying that all Muslims were following Muslim League, but this was another carrot given for Muslims, that you have two alternatives. You can go either in Congress, because that is belonging to everybody, and separate, that is Muslim League. And many times people used to join both. Say for example, after establishment of Muslim League, from 1906 to 1912-13, in that period Muslim League was purely non-political, but after that it activated as political platform also. But still, the barrister Jinnah used to attend both the sessions, that is session of Congress also and session of Muslim League also. Congress was simply union. Say for example, as we are discussing on Sarvajanik Sabha, but after formation of Congress, Sarvajanik Sabha was not merged in Congress. It was working independently at Sarvajanik Sabha. At a time, the people, members of Sarvajanik Sabha, used to enter in Congress. Now, this is something difficult to understand in those as respect to present ideology. But in those days it was going on. So Barrister Jinnah used to attend both the sessions. Now here, Tilak tried to solve the paper this way. Number one, first he carried out union between moderates and extremists. No doubt certain extremist moderate leader. Why I am saying extremist moderate? Because Namdar Gokhale, then Firoz Shah Mehta, like that personalities in Congress, particularly moderate people, they were behaving like moderate in front of Britishers, but they were more extremist, particularly when they were dealing with extremist people. So after death of Firoz Shah Mehta and like that certain extremist moderate, the union of Tilak group with Congress was easily possible. Followed by, he checked out this way, that Lucknow Pact was carried out in 1916, so that Muslims and Muslim League will come close to Congress. For that purpose, he accepted or Congress rather I should say, that accepted the separate electorate for Muslims. Many people are arguing at particular this point because this is the first time exception of this is separatist activity particularly. So first time this activity that is accepted here in Congress, because Congress is actually belonging to the secularist path. Whatever your religion, that is different. But on basis of religion, they allowed to be separate electorate. So many people, particularly those who are against partition, they are saying that from this point, the Congress start bending down. Maybe possible, it is true, but what was the vision of Lokmanya Tilak in particular days? He was not saying, but in politics, in those days, he was in position to challenge out Britishers. And for that purpose, the unity in Indians was main agenda. The way Britishers split out Indian opposites, that was first separating out Muslims, secondly separating out moderates and extremists. In order to overcome that, Tilak also carried out this way, that first there was union between him, moderates and extremists, and secondly it was the union with Muslim leagues. And now they have common platform. For that purpose, they chalk out a plan. Number of separate electorates accepted by Congress, and where these separate electorates should be there, that positions were accepted by Congress, and in return Muslim League also came to fight with Britishers. So the earlier statements that Muslim Leagues, the formation of Muslim League is there just to fight with Congress and Hindus brotherly, and British Empire will remain safe, that become void here, particularly by Lucknow Pact, and that's why Lucknow Pact is important. In particular that period, there was a session that was called as Home Rule League. Rule League was started by Dr. Annie Besant. She was Irish scholar and she used to work in India from 1893 to 1907. She worked in Madras territory. She gathered considerable mass of people and then she started. She was Irish. You are aware that Ireland is just neighboring part of England. If you remember the map, you can discuss. Suppose this is Britain and here is the Ireland. Now she was from this Ireland. Actually almost half of Ireland is there in hands of Britain. We are calling that as United Kingdom. Rather, this is the England, then Wales and Scotland. So we are calling that, this is approximately, so we are calling these all as United Kingdom. Now this way she was in interest of what I feel, that is the enemy of enemies, our friend. Now she was fighting for remaining Ireland. Actually Irish people were fighting for Ireland in those days, and she came to India in order that if she can achieve the target of self-government in India, then that is a major victory, because India was enemy of England at their assumption, and we can separate out India from British rule, then ultimately Britishers were going to lose power and their struggle will be very easy. Like that, maybe possible ideology will be there. So she came to India and started out this. She was working with radicalism, Fabianism, and ultimately her more interest was there in theosophy. the spirituality, and so she was having very good ground in India, and then she started out the Home Rule League. Tilak also joined immediately by starting out same movement in Maharashtra and other parts of India. Now this way, Home Rule League was started, and they challenged out Britishers. Ultimately, Tilak argued this way, that Swarajya is my birthright and I shall have it. Already they were having two newspapers. Initially started by that there was a group of three people, Vishnu Shastri Chipludkar, then Agarkar and Lokmanya Tilak. But unfortunately, Chipludkar died at early age only, and then both of these Kesari and Maratha were in hands of Tilak. Kesari was in Marathi language, whereas Maratha was in English. And Tilak used to write in very precise manner, rude manner also to some extent. And because of that, this become more popular, that exact idea about rule. Like that, certain editorials were there, particularly to rule means not to take revenge. Like that, titles were there for these editorials. And because of that, it has become more popular, particularly he was of aggressive nature only. Now, say for example, his statement about untouchability. Very nice statement. If God were to tolerate untouchability, I would not recognize him as God at all. Like that statement he was making, particularly before 1920s. Now, anyway, this league, that is Home Rule League, worked nice, and ultimately Britishers decided to give next amendment, particularly that is given in form of next law, that is 1990s law, that is called as Montague-Chelmsford law, that is of 1919. Particularly this Montague-Chelmsford Act, that is of 1919, that was given on basis of the following way. In particular 1917, that was period of First World War in Europe, and in order to get some peace from Indian affairs, the Indian minister Montague, he declared that this is the originally emperor's attitude and policy, that should be there, that in every branch or whatever the work is carried out by British Empire, everywhere there should be more and more local, that means Indian people should be installed, and ultimately there should be responsible government in India of Indians. That means whatever Tilak was arguing, that was accepted by Indian minister Montague. And then he came from England to India, Delhi, and there was meeting sessions with Viceroy. That Viceroy was Lord Chelmsford, and then they declared a manifesto that is called as Montford Report, that is Montague and Chelmsford, so we are calling it as Montford Report. Now, it was giving certain rights to Indian, particularly that first thing, within a period of 1 year, on voting basis, they can increase the number of representative in council. Then some important departments should be handled in Indian, particularly And as accepted in Lucknow Pact by Congress and Muslim League, by minor changes, they can allot the separate electorates for Muslims. So this was particularly summarized, we can say. But what is the important thing that is more here, that first time for particular India, they started out bicameral legislature. It is all part of polity. Two houses were discussed here. That first was Council of State, and second, that was Legislative Assembly in central government particularly. Now, in Council of State, total members were 59, whereas 25 were elected.
I'm just writing out.
So two things we have to consider, that is Council of State. Council of State, total members should be 59. Out of that 59, 25 they were selected, whereas remaining 34 they should be elected. So in case of Council of State, they were having total 59 members, out of that 25 selected and 34 elected. Out of that 34 elected candidates, 10 seats were reserved for Muslims. That is, the separate electorate was there, and out of that 10 seats were there for Muslims. Now, in case of Legislative Assembly, total number was of 143. So, Legislative Assembly, total number was 143. Out of that 143 number, the selected candidate were 40. And one or three candidates, they were elected candidates. Out of that 103 candidate, split is like this: 30 were for Muslims, then 9 were there for Europeans, and 2 for Sikhs. So this way they separated out the 103 elected candidates from the elected candidates. Out of that 30 should be Muslims, 9 should be Europeans, and 2 seats were reserved for Sikhs. And here, this way they start out. Now same way in case of provinces. In case of provinces, there was only one house, like that in today's state, we may have two houses, that is Legislative Assembly and Legislative Council. Simply we are calling it as Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad. But in those days, Britishers allowed only one house for provincy, and the number of provinces in those days, that was 8. Name of provinces I am reading out. That is Madras Provincy, that means Chennai today, but in those days it was called as Madras Provincy, almost covering out South India. Then Mumbai Provincy, then Bengal, Mumbai, in those days it was called as Bombay, then Bengal, then Common, then Punjab, Bihar and Orissa, Central Provincy, and Assam. So like that, 8 provinces were there, and it was decided that total 827 members should be there in provinces. Out of that, 190 should be elected. It was 190 selected and 637 elected. Why I am giving you this split? Because first time, some more power was there in hands of Indians. Particularly, here you can observe, I am purposefully keeping this again on board. You can observe here that Britishers were having this ideology that divide and rule. And here, I have to point out this, apart from Muslims, they tried to separate out Sikhs over here. If you are aware thoroughly, these all we are considering as sect. Whatever the Sikhism, Jainism, Buddhism, we are considering as sect. That is the sects in Hinduism. But here, they purposefully identified these religions separately. Now, Sikh, one should not call as separate religion. This is sect in Hinduism. As Savarkar, freedom fighter, he was again and again telling that one should not identify Sikh. Even Sikh should not identify Sikhism as separate religion. It should be considered as sect in Hinduism. But in order to divide and rule, they started on their steps over here and they accepted. Then, whatever the ideology that state was divided into two parts. Certain department like justice, then home department, then irrigation, farming, these departments were in hands of British rulers. Whereas municipal corporation, then health department, education, public work department, like that departments were in hands of Indians. And ultimate, the control on these departments were in hands of governor, and then supreme power was in hands of viceroy. That means, it was not 100% given in our hands. Check was kept on that department also. And that's why, on declaring out this all policy, Lokmanya Tilak immediately argued, this is not at all freedom and foundation of freedom also. He wrote an editorial where he mentioned, Janab, Delhi to bahut dur hai. That means what? We are not having much right, as they were arguing. The furthermore thing, that the period of 10 years was decided. That means this implementation was there for 10 years. And after certain patch, 7 or 8 years, a commission will set out. And that commission will give further report that what new or amendments, if you want, then we have to add, what are the rights next time we can hand it over to Indians. Like that decision was there. Ultimately, this is all cheating because World War was over now. And Indians were not required now in those days. And so they carried out this way. No doubt that Britishers gave this. I want to here just skip out of the topic. But this is really important. What can I say? I can give you an example. That was our class's first trek, where only 6 students were there for a trek. And we 2 teachers were there along with them. That trek was there in jungle, obviously. The place is Harishchandragarh, fantastic place in Maharashtra. So we decided to visit that place. We were having total 8 trekkers now. But the students were too young. They were of just 9th or 10th standard old. And so, initially, they were having no freedom. One teacher was walking in front, leading. 6 students are in between. Last, I was the guard. And we used to march in jungle. Why? There should not be any mishap. Full protection was there in first period. First trek, they enjoyed, but under complete guidance. After say period of 6 months, we carried out another trek where all these 6 students were there, plus 2 or 3 more students were there. Again, same incident was there, that initially these students were completely guarded, but on reaching at top of another fort, we had to visit another place. We visited that. And then students were asked to find out where is our base camp. You can walk further. We both are now at back. We were together, but leadership was given in hands of student. And then they were able to find out path correctly. The next incident was that we asked the student to get down a fort at their own account, because we were quite sure in those days that path was very simple, and now with given experience, student can trace out the path. It was obviously told, if you are having any doubt, you can wait. We are just following you by keeping certain distance. To our knowledge, students perform well. Like that, these students carried out step by step more treks. And after 4th or 5th trek, that they also passed out their requisite classes. And ultimately, they were using to come with us. Okay, sir, we want to go for trek. We were just giving them plan on paper. And then they started carry out their own treks. And they were successful. The thing is that one can guide, and then after initially, it is not that 100% rides were there, but slow and steady, one can get more rides. That was the ideology from British side, but it was too long procedure. 10 years, that procedure was too long. And ultimately, the question is that, how long it will take for Britishers to get entire freedom according to this plan? That was not clear, and therefore Tilak argued this way, that this is not freedom and not at all the foundation of freedom. Now, in this particular Montague Chelmsford reform, the voting right was restricted. Keep in mind, every adult person was not having right of voting in those days. Say for example, if house owner is getting rent, not paying, okay, getting rent of 180 rupees per month, or the farmer who is paying 50 rupees plus, like that, tax or getting revenue or rent, that was criteria, and all of the people were not having voting right. And I hope in modern India also, present days also, suppose this voting right is restricted for these people, then one can expect a nice change in democracy. Obviously, this is every. Now, there was a question from Congress side whether we had to accept this Montague Chelmsford law or not. Tilak was in position to deny this law initially. Reason, that this law was not satisfying what was the expected and what was given, that was not matching one. Surely, after establishment of Congress, that is 1885 to 1919, at least Indians were having knowledge of gathering people together, a run democratic organization. Then the municipal corporations were set up in earlier days. So we were having considerable knowledge about these municipal corporations also. And still, the right was not given. Lokmanya Tilak considered this right even less than municipal corporations, whatever the rights were in hands of Indians. And therefore he was against this. And when there was voting session for Congress about this, he argued that one should not pass out these things. But here you will get different things. Particularly, Muslim League accepted this immediately. Why Muslim League accepted this? Actually, Britishers carried out their divide and rule policy here again. Whatever the demands or say separate electorates were there for Muslims, they offered more than that asked in Lucknow. Actually, this was the loyalty from Muslim League. They should show that they should refuse actually there, that why you are offering us more. But when they received this thing, they accepted immediately, yes. And the remark was given that this law is satisfactory. That means Muslim League again diversified their role. Initially, that means in one year only, they accepted this thing. So what is the impact of Lucknow Pact that was not followed by Muslim League immediately? So this argument was there that Congress was not doing anything, this is not valid. Actually, Lokmanya Tilak and Congress both went out of the way to accept the separate electorates for Muslims, particularly in order to carry out treaty with Muslim League. But they did not follow the unity. The problem was that Muslim League was not taking any participation in freedom struggle. And that is fact. One should not argue like that. And those Muslims, they were really wanted freedom. They were with Congress, like Maulana Azad. He was with Congress. Many other Muslim scholars, they were with Congress and they were engaged in freedom struggle. Apart from Barrister Jinnah, I am taking Barrister Jinnah's name separately because he served a nation lot in earlier days of his life, particularly till 1920, 1921. In particular those days, Barrister Jinnah was of nationalist approach. No doubt he was there in Muslim League, but he was of nationalist approach. And one should not forget that in case of Chapekar, in case of Lokmanya Tilak, whenever the problems were there, Barrister Jinnah was the advocate who fight. Keep in mind, in those days, to become advocate of Savarkar brothers is not joke. British were killed out. That Rand was assassinated. Ayerst was also assassinated over there. And it was a difficult task. It was as equivalent as Sarvajanik Kaka, that is Gava Joshi, G.V. Joshi. Reason that G.V. Joshi also accepted the advocacy of Vasudev Balwant Phadke, the first revolutionist. This was also a difficult task in those days. So same thing was carried out by Barrister Jina. When Lokmanya Tilak was charged by sedition, then also twice the advocate was Barrister Jina. Out of that one time he was not able to get success. But secondly, it was again charged. And at that time, Barrister Jina was successful to save Tilak from this type of sedition. So this is the earlier history of Barrister Jina. But later on, he joined separatist trend. Particularly, at end of Khilafat movement, there was separatist trend. Now here, till this period, it was very clear that Lokmanya Tilak was against wanting the Chelmsford Act. But Muslim League accepted this all Montague-Chelmsford Act and considered that by carrying out this type of move, Britishers are giving very good support to Indians, and this is actually right move by Britishers. So like that comment was also made by Muslim League, particularly in reference to Montague-Chelmsford Act. And ultimately, this is the sign that Muslim League was against Congress, that whatever the Lucknow Pact was there, that is just not actually realistic one. Henceforth, they decided to, again their paths were separated. Now, in all that, one problem was there, that suddenly there was death of Lokmanya Tilak. Why I am using word suddenly? Because no doubt he was suffering from diabetes. That is not a fatal disease like that. Some fever was there for 6 days, and at the end of that fever, on sixth day, Lokmanya Tilak expired. And there was vacuum, and ultimately Gandhiji was able to fill that vacuum. In previous lectures only we have discussed about Gandhiji, the origin, especially entry in Indian politics, particularly the struggles, the successful struggles Gandhiji carried out, especially I can say that in India he was quite successful, particularly in Champaranya, Kheda, followed by Ahmedabad strike of mill workers. But the action of against Rowlatt Act, that proved to be more problematic. Particularly non-violence and violence struggle was there. Even Churchill, Winston Churchill, commented on this struggle, this incident of Jallianwala Bagh Hatta Kand, whatever we are saying. That was very, very effective. He says that this type of strategy was new for British Empire. Obviously, he must not have observed what was there in 1857 revolt, but he commented like that. So anyway, we can say that was the struggle between violent people and non-violence. Now, Gandhiji entered in Indian politics, particularly in earlier fight, he was successful because according to moderate, Gandhiji was moderate. According to extremist, he was using the technique of movement, that is the extremism only. And no doubt revolutionaries thought this way, that no doubt Gandhiji is against violence, but that is his strategy, particularly that to continuously speak against violent, but he is somewhat revolutionarist. His concept of Satyagraha, that was also revolutionarist. And so, in Congress initially he was well accepted. But the problem was there after death of Tilak. After death of Lokmanya Tilak, it was the situation that Britishers only accepted your right to rule, that is Swaraj, Swarajya means actually self-government. As we have discussed earlier, way also that there is no clear-cut idea between Swarajya and Swatantrya. That means self-government and freedom. Many time they were asking about Swarajya. That means freedom. That means self-government. Self-government means something like that, as we have discussed earlier. Whatever today in India state government are having, that we can say self-government. Whereas Swarajya, Swatantrya means freedom, that particularly Indian government is enjoying, that is the freedom. That means entire freedom from British rule, that is we are considering here freedom. Whereas Swarajya, that means self-government, is something different, where we can mutually understand this way that there should be home department, then foreign department, and certain army like defense like departments. This should be in hands of Britishers, that means empire, whereas remaining department should be in hands of local people. That is called as self-government. And obviously, Gandhiji proposed out this way, that we have to start out non-cooperation movement. Now Gandhiji fused out different concept. That non-cooperation movement is tie-up with Khilafat movement. We have discussed that, why Khilafat movement was there, what was the aim of Khilafat movement, and then Gandhiji started out this Khilafat, support for Khilafat movement. And combiningly, this movement started all over in India. Gandhiji was there in Congress, and particularly in Congress committee. The meeting was there particularly to discuss about Khilafat movement and non-cooperation movement. And at that time, Barrister Jinnah opposed for this non-cooperation movement. Barrister Jinnah was here somewhat, we can say, practically he was saying. According to him, we are right now, we are not prepared. We are not in position that we are 100% prepared to start out non-cooperation movement. His words are something different. When he was there to speak, he said this way, what I want to tell Mr. Gandhi. The moment he said Mr. Gandhi, someone from crowd immediately replied, why you are saying Mr. Gandhi? Address him as Mahatma Gandhi. Barrister Jinnah opposed that. He again said, what I want to say Mr. Gandhi. And then entire crowd starts shouting out. But you should not say Mr. You should address him properly as Mahatma. So ultimately Jinnah tried to complete his speech. But the people, the crowd did not allow him. Resulting Jinnah was insulted. And ultimately, he was forced to leave the stage, the podium, the stage, he left. And then onwards, he never came on the Congress platform. Actually, Gandhiji was there on the stage. He should have interrupted. That okay, you let him continue what he want to tell. Because Britishers were never calling him Mahatma. Then why one can expect that everybody should call him Mahatma? And obviously, Jinnah was also a senior member. He was not a young one that he should respect him like that only, as other people are doing. What is the meaning of freedom then? Everybody is having different ideology. Those who accept this ideology that Gandhiji is Mahatma, they can call him Mahatma. Why others are forced? And in that matter, say I am not siding out Jinnah, but the matter is that important message given by Jinnah that was not conveyed properly here. Instead of that, actually Jinnah should also speak like that, okay, Mahatma, what is the difference that? I want to address him as Mr. or Mahatma, that is a different question. He is at that position only, but Jina also was rigid in nature, and Gandhiji was also rigid in nature, resulting the important free discussion was not carried out, and ultimately Jina was beside her, and ultimately he left out Congress from that point. He was insulted tremendously, and then Gandhiji started out this non-cooperation movement all over India. The non-cooperation works very nicely. Whenever possible that people resigned from government officers, majority Muslims resigned because they supported Khilafat movement. Hindus also resigned, but to less number as compared to Muslims, and resulting that the movement actually started very nicely. But one incident was there, that was unwanted incident, that was there in Uttar Pradesh. Chauri Chaura is the place, you are aware of that. Actually, one march was there, peaceful march was there, and unnecessarily that police started out fight. And in that one person died, and so many get injured in that. Resulting, during night, the mob attacked police station and fired. If you can fire, we can also fire. And some 22 policemen were died in that. Gandhiji was not expecting this type of movement. He was expecting complete non-violent movement. According to Satyagraha, the thing is that opposition, or the one who is carrying out injustice, must evoke in his mind that I am carrying out injustice. It's not forcefully we can do that. And that's why the movement must be carried out by non-violent manner only. And at that time, Gandhiji immediately stopped this movement, taken back this movement, and he was imprisoned immediately by British. He was arrested, imprisoned, and this non-cooperation movement stopped. The outbreak of this incident was something different, and separatist trend flourished particularly. There was violent anti-Hindu outburst in Kohat, in northwest frontier province, in September 24, leaving 155 dead. Only dead number is given here. Three waves of riots were there in Calcutta between April to July 26, where 138 killed. Totally in UP particular, not less than 91 communal outbreaks occurred. All of these incidents showing that initially there was Hindu-Muslim unity, particularly Muslim League was united with Congress. Then they started out a movement, Right League, that is non-cooperation movement. But at end of this non-cooperation movement, there was violent outbreak between Hindus and Muslims. The worst attack was there in Mopla district, that is called as a Malabar district, part of Malabar district in Kerala. The Arab Muslims were mixed up with Indian Muslims. That community is called as Mopla community. There was rebellion from Mopla. No doubt, for so many days or weeks, they were able to govern, a sort of self-government from British side. But later on, that was ended by introduction of army from Nepal. The army was set over there, Gurkha army was set over there, and this incident was crushed. Everywhere, the outbreak of communal riots were there, particularly after the end of this non-cooperation movement. Now, The thing is that Gandhiji was following the Hindu-Muslim unity principle. Congress was not only belonged to Hindus, it belonged to all people, all Indians, and obviously non-Indian also, because it was established by Alan Hume. Then Dr. Annie Besant was also president of Congress. No doubt she was working for India, but she was not of Indian origin. She was from Ireland, but she was also enjoyed presidentship of Congress. Then here, particularly this patch between 1922 to 1927, there was a peaceful way, particularly no direct movements were carried out. Indirectly, everywhere work was going on, like spread of Swadeshi. We had to use Charkha, we had to use clothes of Khadi, boycott Western good, even protest against alcoholism, and so many very nice thing. The constructive work was carried out, in particularly with respect to this incident. Now, we have to discuss slight different part from henceforth, because we have to introduce here some concepts, that is capitalism, communism, socialism, Nazism, all these concepts we have to discuss. So I am ending out this lecture over here, and now we are discussing about these different ways, that communism, capitalism, etc. here in next lecture.